has reportedly given assurances to the United States that Tehran is not seeking to kill the American president-elect, and that would be Donald Trump. This comes as tensions between the two countries continue to grow, with Iran displaying missiles and defense systems in a new exhibit on the heels of a visit from the UN nuclear watchdog chief Rafael Grossi. Our senior correspondent Bianca Zanini wraps it up. Take a look.
On display, a warning for Israel and the U.S. as tensions between the West and the Islamic Republic of Iran continue to rise. Iran's Revolutionary Guard Corps showcasing a number of its missile and defense systems, some of them capable of reaching Israel and U.S. bases in the region.
I felt so proud that we have boosted our defensive power to the extent that the aggressors can't even think about attacking us.
The show of force comes as the world awaits an Iranian retaliatory strike on Israel after the IDF targeted military sites in Iran in late October in response to a previous Iranian attack. Tehran has reportedly said they will wait to respond until after U.S. President-elect Donald Trump takes power.
We're going to bring peace. You're going to have peace in the Middle East.
Meanwhile, Trump is expected to reinstate his sanctions-led maximum pressure policy on Tehran to prevent it from acquiring nuclear weapons. Leading up to the weekend, Rafael Grossi, the UN nuclear watchdog chief, visited Tehran in an effort to restart negotiations. But in an interview with Iranian state television, the country's foreign minister, Abbas Araghchi, said that an opportunity for nuclear diplomacy with the West is limited. Araghchi also addressed reports that Iran's ambassador to the UN held a secret meeting with Trump supporter billionaire Elon Musk, discussing the growing tensions, Araghchi denying any opening of talks.
No, it definitely did not happen. It was simply fabrication by American media.
According to U.S. intelligence, Iran is armed with the largest number of ballistic missiles in the Middle East.
Well, joining us now is Andrea Stricker. She's the Non-Proliferation and Biodefense Program Deputy Director at the Foundation for Defense of Democracies. So to begin, should we be taking Iran's word for it? Is Iran really not interested in taking out Donald Trump?
Well, good evening. Thank you for having me. I think we can realistically expect that no, Iran likely will not try to assassinate Trump while he's president, simply because this would mean the end of the regime when America would retaliate. However, I think his security team has to take those plots seriously and seek to disrupt any active plots just in case. But the Biden administration has really done very little to make clear to Tehran that this kind of activity and Iranian malign actions overall will not be tolerated. But I think Trump's election and the return of the U.S. willingness to use force to make clear to its adversaries that they can't go on like this is already creating a sort of a cooling off in the region and beyond.
Now, the Islamic Republic has showcased a number of its missile and defense systems, some of them capable of reaching Israel and also American bases in the region. But how worried should Israel and the U.S. be about the Iranian threat at this point, following Israel's widespread and widely deemed successful retaliatory strikes on Iranian military infrastructure last month?
Well, certainly Iran has the capability to launch massive missile and drone attacks against Israel. That hasn't changed. What Israel did, though, by taking out its capability to quickly build new missiles, as well as its air defenses, means the regime has to think twice about carrying out an attack like this. If it would strike now, it stands to lose major additional missile facilities, potentially economic and oil production sites, and potentially nuclear sites. So I do believe that they won't retaliate while Trump is coming into office.
Now, Israel reportedly hit an Iranian nuclear research facility as well. How may Iran respond if this report does turn out to be true?
I actually don't think Iran will respond. So Israel really did something ingenious here by hitting a facility associated with Iran's undeclared nuclear program. That's a facility that the IAEA, the nuclear watchdog, does not safeguard. Allegedly, this facility, Taligan 2, was involved in some renewed experiments that would help the regime set off a nuclear weapon. But Israel stayed under the president's red line of not targeting the major nuclear sites, because in order to protest, Iran would have had to admit that it was violating its nuclear nonproliferation treaty obligation not to work on nuclear weapons. Right. So Israel really did the world a service here by creating a potential bottleneck in the program.
All right. Andrea Stricker joining us from the States. Thank you for that breakdown. Very interesting to hear about the report on the nuclear facility more specifically.